Now, the next step is, of course, actually downloading this template from a case. To do that, we're going to visit a case profile here. And depending on the setup of your profile, you'll want to find your document tab. Typically, they're towards the bottom or at the bottom of the profile, but again, that could change a little bit depending on your configuration. The case documents tab is going to show us any documents that have already been added to this particular case. So we see here that this case doesn't have any documents yet. And then we've got our document templates tab. So this is where we'll see all of those documents that match the criteria for this case and are available to download for the case. We see our test template for webinar, which is the one that we built together today. And we'll notice that download button here. I'm going to click download. It will, of course, download to my computer. And it will open up in whatever you have as your default. And we can see here that it's actually pulling all of those merge shields right from our case. So we can see our client name. We can, of course, see our case ID, our problem code, and our primary assignment name. The other thing that will happen when you download this template is it will also automatically add it as a case document. So if we refresh here, we'll see under generated documents, which is the folder that's created for templates, we'll see that test template here. So of course, now that's added to our document folder on the case, we can come and download this document whenever we need to. So if we need to print out a copy of it and give it to the client or whatever we have to do, that is always going to be available on the case there for you. So that is everything for document templates and mapping of the document templates. I don't see any more questions in the queue, but I will go ahead and leave the webinar open for just a couple of minutes. So if you have any questions remaining, please feel free to type those in now. There's a question, is there a way to create a custom date field such as 10 days after current date? So in your template mappings, you've got a today's date, which is the only smart kind of date field available. So you can have whatever custom fields that you want. Those all custom fields or site-specific fields that you build in Legal Server will be available to map to in that case information actor. But we don't have the availability to map to a field that's based on another field as far as the date. So no automatic kind of dates like that. Again, the today's date is really the only kind of magic field that automatically gets set in templates.